So today we'll discuss about what software testers think about bugs and what are the things that you should consider while raising bugs and the things around it. So these are some points that I have collected from a book. The credits goes to the Test Chat community who has run an initiative called as 21 Days, 21 Tips, where on LinkedIn people have given various suggestions who are testers. So I have read that book. This is that book. It is of 112 pages. So I completed that. And I have in that there are tips related to testing in all the direction and there are general tips. So I will be making a series of videos on that. So let me begin. I'll just talk about bugs in this particular video. So there is a mind map I that created. So let's begin. So the first point is focus on the bug, not on the person. Sometimes, like especially when you newly join in testing, you will feel that your bugs are getting rejected by a senior developer or the people in the development team. So your job is to raise the bug and allow the product owner to decide whether it has to be fixed or not. So don't fight over that or just focus on bug, not on the person is the first point. And do risk analysis. For example, sometimes you find some corner bugs which might not happen in production because you have the access to the back end where you change some configuration, but in actually it might not happen. And if it can happen, then you should add sufficient evidence with it or the scenarios that can happen and can impact production, right? So that there is no to and fro, like people say that it might not come. So you already have put your analysis in the bug itself, right? And do follow up on your bugs, not follow up to get them fixed. Sometimes testers take it to the heart that, oh, I have raised it and I should get it fixed. No. Leave that decision to the product owner to decide whether they want the bug to be fixed or not. Don't get disheartened if your bug is not getting fixed. It's their call whether to get that fixed or deferred. So when I say conclusion, it does not mean getting fixed. It means it's deferred or they don't want to fix it. They will fix it later, like that, right? And the next important activity come is RCA, root cause analysis. Right? Generally, root cause analysis must be done so that you have lessons learned, you know why that bug came. And when you know it, the next time when the bugs will come, you will be conscious and you will be checking those areas. So for S1 and S2 bugs, it must be conducted if you don't have time for S3 and S4, right? And you will have lessons, like for example, as I mentioned, one of the advice shared by one of the testers, like when you zoom a lot, sometimes the functionality of some of the pages get broken, right? So that's a lessons learned and that you will use the next time. Yeah, and get out of this that whether a bug is small or raised, small or big, right? You might be considering from your perspective that it's small. If there are thousands of users who are using it, then it becomes a bigger one, right? And do have correct priorities so that you can get those bugs fixed first, which can happen. There are chances of happening that in productions is more, right? Suppose there are four P1 bugs, right? Or I would say P3 in this case, or S3 bugs, right? In that case, you have less time. So you should, if the priority or severity is same, then you should be able to tell that, okay, there are more chances of that bug to happen first, right? So that can be fixed. Yeah, this is my blog. You can visit it to keep on getting such videos. I will be creating more on these topics, right? And next comes the topic of what you are attaching to the bug, right? It's not just the screenshot. You should attach, like, if there is a recording, because sometimes in screenshots you can't cover it, you can have recording. And logs are very important because logs help to debug to develop for the developer. Like, suppose you are logging into a website and there is an error. You simply say that while logging, it's failing, right? So that does not give information very accurately. So the developer might ping you in another 1 hour or next day that he's not able to reproduce. So test data plays an important role. Like you should place the test data. And if you have access to you should understand how you can see application and server logs. For example, I'll give you a recent example. It happened in one of my projects that one of the API was running perfectly fine via Postman, but it was not running somehow via automation code in Python. So when I looked into the Azure, like in Azure, there is monitoring in cloud services. There is a monitoring provided. So I went into the logs and server and Azure diagnostics. So there I saw that there is one of the rules which is blocking automation. So I simply told the development team that this is the rule which is blocking it, because they would have to do the same investigation and they would have to run the same scenario. So that way I had a learning as well. And next time I can solve some of the bugs myself as well. Right. So all these things are important, logs, right? And logs can be of various type, like application logs. Sometimes you do right click inspect and you check whether the network elements, their 400 is coming or 404 is coming or 200 is coming. So logs, device logs, network logs. So these are various kind of log. And what is the situation of server? Like if you are performing a certain scenario, the server should not be consuming lots of memory. Like you are running a suppose a stored procedure and it's taking 90% of server. So that should not happen. Those things also you should look at. And yes, the description of the bug should be detailed enough. When I say detailed enough, it's not like filling up the English language over there, but relevant details, not such details that a layman can understand it, but your team should understand it. Right, I should not be writing this should come, open the website in Chrome browser, right? And then the title should appear. So it can be detailed, but detailed in such a way that you can understand it when you look at it 10 days after or 1 month after it. And your team who is working, who knows the in and out of the system, they should be able to understand it. But when you write just a one or two liner, then sometimes it's difficult, but in situation, it could be valid as well. Right. And yeah, try to before raising a bug, try to reproduce it more than once, because sometimes it happens that the bug is not coming the second time. Right. Then the developer will come back to you that it's not coming. And sometimes it's due to the mistake that we do. For example, some of the examples are network glitch or browser cache. Right. So sometimes you have not taken the latest build. So when you give it a retry, you confirm that, yes, it's coming. Even if it is coming one time, I'm not saying that you should ignore it. You should raise it, right? Even an observation, you should not take the decision that whether according to you, it's good or bad, just raise it, right? So yeah, this is the full mind map. I would be adding it on my blog as well from where you can take it. And thanks for watching. I would be coming up with more such videos. You can subscribe and press the bell icon and subscribe to my blog as well. Thanks for watching.